Uplift yourself by the power of your own mind. Do not degrade yourself. For the controlled mind will be your best friend. And the uncontrolled mind will be your own worst enemy. Thoughts can make us happy and thoughts can make us sad. So then why don't we think good thoughts? When you clean your house, and supposing Swamiji comes with the garbage can and he empties it in your drawing room, what will you do? You will probably show a revolver, "Swamiji, clean it all up." So you don't allow garbage into your house. Then why do you allow garbage into your head? The kind of thoughts we think, all this garbage inside we keep. It is high time we get it all out, because thoughts will have consequences. If you want to do good karma, good actions, then the seed of that is your thoughts. Thoughts are the seeds, actions are the plants that grow from them. From bad seeds, bad plants will grow. There's a bichhu vriksh in India. Out here you've got poison ivy. The seed is like that, the plant is like that. So if you want to have good plants, you sow the good seeds. If you want to do good deeds, then keep good thoughts. Now your thoughts are all mediocre and you think you will do spectacular work. This will violate the basic laws of God. So understand, if you want to improve your work, then you improve your thoughts. And if you don't improve them, God will force you to improve them. How is that? That is the university of hard knocks that I tell you all about. If you are keeping always thoughts of anger, then God will send to you an adosi padosi, a neighbor who will always keep making you angry. Because God will show you, look, become aware of your defect inside. He will repeatedly expose you to your defect so that you are forced to face it and try and improve it. In other words, the whole universe is adjusted in such a way to help you purify, to help you improve, to help you move ahead. So until you move ahead, the same situation will keep on repeating again and again. God is telling you, improve yourself from the inside. Some people don't even realize the gap. The mind is different, I am different. People who are too emotional, they ride the roller coaster of emotions. Oh, I am feeling so devotional. Oh, I am not feeling devotional. So what to do now? Now wait for the next wave to come. Now again I'll feel devotional. So people who don't have control over the mind, they make statements like this. Swamiji, I don't feel any bhakti any longer. So what to do? Now I'll wait for the feeling to come back. Are Baba. The first step in Atma Kalyan is to bring your feelings under your control. In other words, to generate the good feelings is bhakti. Not to wait for it to happen. The same kind of statement they will make in the world. Swamiji, I don't feel any love for my spouse now. So what to do? I don't know what to do. Arey, love is a verb. Love is not an emotion. You have to create those positive sentiments. So to think positively towards God and Guru is bhakti, not to wait for it to happen. In other words, you have to take charge of your mind, and then you realize that this mind has troubled me for so many lifetimes. Now I have to become the master of my mind. And when you tap into the power of the controlled mind, it will become positive, it will become cheerful, it will become optimistic. You will get all the beneficial attitudes. In other words, those who are successful, they know how to control the mind and keep an attitude that will be helpful. And those who don't succeed, they fail in keeping positive, proper attitudes. So they get tripped by their own thoughts. That is why our job is to bring these thoughts under control. There are so many thoughts that keep impinging upon us. Where do they come from? Our own mind creates them. They don't come from anywhere. This mind is the factory of thoughts. Now, if you have worked on your mind and made it somewhat pure, it will produce for you good thoughts, nice thoughts. And if you have allowed your mind to degenerate, then the mind will create unproductive thoughts, unholy thoughts. The mind is the same. Just like you have a garden plot. Now either you weed out all the wild grass and then seed it with the beneficial crop that you want and take good care of it, then you'll be a nice gardener and you'll get a nice garden. And if the gardener does not tend to the garden, the earth will in any case create wild grass. So it will become full of wild grass. And that will bring more of its kind, and that will bring more of its kind, until you've got a wild plot. Same is the nature of this mind. Either you tend to it, pull out the unwholesome thoughts, or you let the mind be by itself. The mind will not be thought-free. It will create its own thoughts. And then like that wild plot, you will have a mind that will impede your own happiness, fulfillment, and success. That is why we are the gardeners of our own mind. And we should be very careful to uproot thoughts that don't help us and to replace them with such thoughts that can transform us.